It might be one of the oldest college football stadiums in the country, but that doesn't mean Camp Randall isn't wild. We're in Madison, getting set for a great game. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke tastes, zero calories. Enjoy everything. The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. He's tackled at the 29-yard line. Wisconsin's a team and a program that year in, year out's got 1,000-yard rushers. Sometimes they've got two, and they've got that huge offensive line. And, you know, you get too worried about them, and sometimes you can overlook the fact they can throw the ball.
It's going to be tough today for this defense. I think they're going to have to take some chances and load this line of scrimmage. And, you know, as a play caller for this offense, when you have such a gifted running back, it opens up every aspect of the offense. I mean, the play-action pass with this running game, you get those linebackers and safeties coming up close to the line of scrimmage. It's a great time to really open up and show what you can do as a complete offense. It'll be a challenge.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 47-yard line. Nice run there. Taylor gets 6 yards on the play. On the ground, and he won't get back to the line.
The D-line did a good job of nullifying out the blocks up front, and that allowed the linebacker to roam free and make the tackle in the backfield.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 43. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He's knocked out of bounds around the 35-yard line. Good gain on the pass to the running back.
This young man is becoming more and more part of this passing game. He does a great job of making guys miss after the catch.
On play action. Tackle around the 18-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 18-yard line. Brought down at about the 17-yard line.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air for the play-action pass.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. They've got their goal line sets on the field. This might be a good time for play-action. Shows some moves and he's in. Move to get into the end zone.
There's a perfect play call. They look like they practiced that one a few times.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. An 8-play, 71-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. They line up to kick this one away. From the 5-yard line. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. He's scrambling, and he has it on the corner. He's to the 40. He's at midfield, and he's level at the 48. from the 48-yard line. First down.
Come on out here. Come get some. Come get some. Come on here. Come get some. Green nine. Green.
Zips it to the back. And they hit him in the backfield. Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 50. He scrambled. And he's tackled at the 42-yard line.
To expect on third down, and we're right in place to break up the pass.
They'll call on the field goal unit. Kicks up, and it's no good. It lands short. Not a very good attempt there for the senior kicker. So our count is still 7-0, Wisconsin. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in 6. Wisconsin up 7 points. He makes it to the 45-yard line. Second down and 6. Ball on the 45. A little toss across the middle. They'll bring him down at the 44-yard line. And a nice pickup there.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz, and the quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line. From the 41-yard line, it's second down. They go with a run, and he's brought down in the backfield.
Man left, man left. Four down, four down. Mike eight, Mike eight. They go.
Wants to go long and done. And this one's going to get intercepted.
The defense really cranked up the heat there. Give those guys all the credit for forcing a desperation pass.
We've got a first and 10, ball on their own 16. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 23-yard line. And he's taken down right around the 44-yard line.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long range yards.
It's first and 10, ball on the 44.
Three down, three down. Hey, watch that, watch that. Three!
Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. And down he goes at the 48-yard line. Made around the 48-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. Scrambling around, and they make the stop at the 47-yard line.
You admire their faith in the running game, but a pass might have been the better way to go.
Big kick here to try to pin the offense deep in their own territory. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. The offense will take the field, hoping for a better result than their last drive.
He can't dwell on the interception. There's still a whole lot of football to be played today.
Hands it off. Tackled after a decent pickup. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Wisconsin is up a score. He's on the run. He's to the 40. He gets hit out of bounds around the 45-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 45. Makes it to the 47. To the back. He airs it out. Huge gain, and that sets him up nicely with a first and goal. Now it's first and goal with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Just gets rid of it.
Hey, they're scared. They're scared. My game. Go.
Looking for the corner. Touchdown, Badgers. The extra point. A nice 6-play, 80-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. So our score, 14-0. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he'll return this one from the 7. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Wisconsin's defense is playing lights out right now and pitching a shutout.
Yeah, I would not be shocked at all to see this defense be able to maintain this. Just the way they're playing, the attitude that they seem to be playing with, if they can maintain the energy and the awareness of this offense, there's a very good shot that they could shut this offense out.
Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. And now the ball is loose. That was a close one, but the ball goes out of bounds. Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on their own 33. He's taken down at the 34-yard line. Gets it. He's in space. He's out of bounds at the 42. From their own 42-yard line, first down. and he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. The right side. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Dumps it right to his fullback. And he tackles him hard at the 41-yard line. It's a ball left side. He gets out to about the 38-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. And they get nice yardage on that run. They line up for another third down, and they've had no problem converting their first two. And he is drilled at the 23. And this is the 10th play of the drive. He goes out of bounds at the 21-yard line. From the 21-yard line, second down. He's going to try and scramble, heading for the corner. Inside the 10, he's pushed out of bounds around the 4-yard line. And this is the 12th play of the drive.
I'm coming.
And the goal line defense digging in here.
And two, three, nine.
Going to the end zone. Touchdown for the tight end. Tacks on the extra point.
It was a 12-play, 68-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
The score now, 14-7, and he's taken down at the 30. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Wisconsin is up by a touchdown. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
That's not what you hope for from your running game. You're looking for some solid north and south progress. You never want to give the defense a play like that to build their confidence.
Second down, 14 coming up here. Ball on the 26-yard line. He lets it go. Caught. Brought down. Right around the 48-yard line. Out to about the 44-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Tackle at about the 41.
Right and left, right and left. Two down, two down.
dumps it complete, the tight end over the middle.
If you're the defense, who do you try to cover this guy with? He's too fast for most linebackers. He's too big for most corners. You have to rely on your safeties, who generally aren't very good in one-on-one coverage.
He's tackled around the 19-yard line. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Wisconsin is up 7. He gets out to about the 11-yard line.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Touchdown, Wisconsin! Hits the PAT. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit. Flag on the play. Let's see what it is.
That's frustrating for a coach when you preach fundamentals every week and then have someone called for clipping. That penalty really is going to set them back.
The offense ready for the first play of this drive. They move the ball extremely well on their last possession on their way to the end zone.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator has got to be livid. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
And they hit him in the backfield. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of 1. From their own 23-yard line, second down. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
This wide receiver is very frustrated. You can tell by his body language. He did everything he needed to do to get open to be able to make a big play. The quarterback just didn't put the ball in the money.
Here's the halfback on the screen. And he's tackled around the 36-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 36. Flags are all over the place, and they'll blow it dead. That penalty will move them back a bit.
Yeah, with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
Slings it out, and it gets tipped.
This is a well-prepared defense. They know where to be, and they know what their opponent likes to do. They play tight coverage as well.
From their own 31-yard line, second down. Pulls it in and stopped in his tracks with that tackle. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Him hard at the 47.
The defense might need to make some changes to their coverage scheme because that was just too easy.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. Complete, and he's hit right away.
This is smart, efficient play calling. You don't need to make the highlight reel on each play.
From the 43-yard line, it's second down. room around the corner. Good open field tackle. He's on the run, and he's going to be sacked for a loss. Fourth down. They call on the kicker for a long field goal. Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
Done. The return man. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. So the Badgers' game plan is just what we've been seeing through a couple of quarters now. Give this guy the football and let him ram it down the defense's throat and just keep giving it to him until he gets tired or the defense gets tired.
Well, the offensive line, I also think, deserves a lot of credit. You know, the back is the star. He's been getting most of the yards and most of the attention, but he's not doing it alone. The offensive line's paving the way and opening this thing up, and the running back's taking advantage of it. They've had a great first half.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. So we've played two quarters. The Badgers in front, 21-7.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half.
These teams only play one game a week, only 12 games in a normal regular season. I think fans have a hard time understanding why their squad can come out and play without any energy, any emotion. Keep it real with us. Tell us what it's like. Why is it hard for a player sometimes in a game like this?
Well, if the fans showed the same emotion, then maybe we would too as a player. Because think about it. When I walk out there and I'm playing one of the big dogs, the stadium's rocking. They're going crazy. They're going ballistic. They're hydrated. You know exactly what's going on. They're into it. They've been tailgating for hours. Well, there's a reason these little games, they don't get up for us. They don't get as excited. They're not yelling and screaming as much. That you could turn the, it's like you turn the volume down at home. I mean, you can hear the difference. I know the difference. I know I'm supposed to beat this opponent. It's really a matter of just by how much I'm supposed to win by. So there is a difference. You can feel it in the fans, and you can feel it sometimes as a player.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And down he goes, right around the 24-yard line. From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. Makes it out to about the 40.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working. Doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
Scrambling around. Tackle made at the 48-yard line. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Pulls it in, and that's a first down. They'll bring him down at the 36-yard line. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. And he's level at the 36. This is the eighth play of this drive. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And he's taken down at about the 27-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Tackled for a loss. Tenth play of the drive. Takes it, and he's tackled short. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. Kicks up. So the senior kicker is unsuccessful this time. Still, our score, 21-7, Wisconsin. Here comes the offense as they look to find the end zone yet again.
Three down. Mike eight.
On the ground, inside. Can't wrap him up. And they make the stop right around the 46-yard line. From the 46-yard line, it's first down. Cavalry's coming, and he's sacked.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
Man left.
From the 47-yard line, second down. He's taken down around the 48-yard line. They go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. And he's tackled in the open field. Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Wisconsin's game plan was to run the ball, and they are doing it brilliantly.
Well, they knew coming in that they'd have to be able to rely on running the football. So far, so good. We'll see how it plays out the rest of the second half.
Zips it to the back. Only 3 yards there on the throw.
The offense is trying to get the ball into the hands of the halfback here, and he did a pretty good job of getting a few yards, but the defense was just swarming to the ball right there.
Second down and 7 coming up here. Ball on their own 23. Here's the halfback. He makes it to the 25-yard line. Now he's scrambling. Brought down at the 35-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 35-yard line. Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. Tackle right around the 36-yard line. The catch. It's first and 10. Ball on the 48. He's going to try and scramble.
It's a fumble. Picks up the fumble.
He's tackled at the 49-yard line. Scrambled, and he's tackled around the 40-yard line. From the 40-yard line, first down. Here comes the pressure. Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receiver.
You know, Brad, this is one of those plays where the quarterback just wants to apologize to the wide receiver, maybe every other member of this offense. The wide receiver, if he's smart, will come up to that quarterback, tell him to forget about it. Let's move on to the next play.
He fights forward to about the 39. A man down, and he's in some pain right now. And this is the 10th play of the drive. Intercepted.
He seemed a little hesitant on that throw, and that left the defender time to break on the ball and pick it off.
First and 10. Ball on their own 9. Across the middle. Tight end's got it. And down he goes, around the 21-yard line. Makes it out to about the 29. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Quick throw to the tight end. Tackle made at about the 35. Well, this turned out to be a pretty good ball game, and we've got 1 quarter to go. Wisconsin's in front by 14. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4.
Three down. My gate.
Good outside run there. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Throws this one away. He gets out to about the 42-yard line. The 27. The quarterback comes back on the field, and I'm sure he's hoping to make up for that interception on the last drive.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
Room around the corner. Good tackle there in space. Second down and eight. Ball on the 30-yard line. The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call. Well, that penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
Tries to buy some time. They'll bring him down at about the 33-yard line. He scrambles there for about 8 yards. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. He's on the run, and they get the sack. Done. Awaiting the return. And down he goes at the 38-yard line.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop.
Fires it out. Tackled right away. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. He fights forward to around midfield. Taken down at the 42. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Four down, My gate.
There go. 225. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. Out to about the 38-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. Taylor gets the call again. He makes it to the 35-yard line.
Double tight, double tight. Four down, four down.
than 3 minutes in the game. And they'll bring him down behind the line.
When this guy gets his arms around a ball carrier, I don't care who it is, he's not getting away.
So we're looking at another third down here. He unloads it, stays in bounds, and made a nice catch. Pretty good gain right there.
You know, the thing that impresses me about this offense is their ability to spread the ball around. They're not afraid to go to their tight ends, their tailbacks, and in this case, their fullback. Nicely designed play.
He fights forward to about the 20. A 1 yard gain by the halfback. It's second and 9. Ball on the 20 yard line. He fights forward to about the 19. The halfback picks up a yard. And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. And he can't stay in bounds, but they'll have it first and goal. Wisconsin with a first and goal here. And this defense needs a stop or this game could get out of reach.
Quickly out there in the passing game between a quarterback and his receivers and tight ends. Here, the quarterback does a good job of putting the ball up there to be able to be played by the tight end. The problem is the tight end's looking at the football and trying to keep his foot in bounds, and I just think he lost an awareness of where he was on the field. He was so focused on making a catch on the football, he wasn't able to get a foot down for the catch.
And this is the 15th play of the current drive. A little over a minute in the game. Badgers know that they have to enjoy this guy while they've got him, because somewhere down the line he's going to be at the next level.
Well, that'll definitely be in his future, but for now he needs to sit back and just enjoy this performance, and really the play caller, the quarterback, the offensive line, the receivers, the entire group as just a whole should feel good about their performance.
For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.